I should say first that there's no substitute for memorizing math facts. Someone who wants to do mathematics has to know the basic facts in the same way that a musician has to know the scales or a historian has to know the names and dates and places of history. There's just no substitute for a certain amount of basic technical facility. But on the other hand, if all you're doing in math or in any of these subjects is just memorizing facts, you won't get to see the reason for these facts or kind of the what they're leading towards. You know, I could use an analogy that, you know, if you're a chef, you have to know how to measure spices or how to heat food or, you know, how long to cook and prepare things. But, you know, if you never actually tasted food, you wouldn't really get the main point of the basic human activity of cooking. What makes cooking so interesting is not all the technical steps, which of course a cook has to know, but kind of the overall picture and the way it's organized. So I'd say that my book, You Can Count on Monsters, is, you know, kind of closer to a cooked meal. It's sort of, you know, in reading it, you have to know the basic facts. It kind of forces you to understand the basics as you read through it. But on the other hand, it kind of organizes them towards a kind of a higher purpose. The other thing I'd say along those lines is that sometimes when you learn low-level things, it's important to know what the high-level application is. For example, there's this famous exercise where you have to describe to someone how to tie your shoe. So if I just said to you, well, you pick up the left strand and you make a loop and then you pick up the right strand and you thread it through the loop, et cetera, but I didn't tell you that you were trying to tie a shoe, you know, it could take you hours to get it done. But if I just said, look, your purpose is to tie a shoe, then as you're doing these kind of low-level steps, you sort of understand what the purpose is, and then it will sort of, you know, give you a guide towards kind of organizing those steps in a better way, a way that'll make them easier to learn. It's the same thing with dancing. I mean, if you just say left foot out, left foot back, turn around, it's kind of very hard to understand what the dance is about. But if you say, well, here's an arabesque and so on, you actually can, you know, you can dance right away. So, you know, that's the difference between, you know, just memorizing facts and reading a book like You Can Count on Monsters. The Monsters book gives you the dance and not just the dance steps.